Namaste everyone, Rishi Gupta here from 25 TeraWatts, and today I'll dive deep into how I came into being an agency owner in the field of AI, in the field of energy, to cut down human effort and enable people to do more of what they love and less of what they don't. AI is not just ChatGPT, it's so much more. This is logic-based reasoning, which is mostly done by software programming, where you design an algorithm, take an input, enter it into this intelligence, and it gives you an output. The intelligence is able to call upon resources, which can be things like just a lot of the information in the world, like what ChatGPT does, but it could also be as confined as in spell check. So spell check was one of the most simplest and early applications of AI that a lot of people forget. Well, if you've used spell check, you have used AI. So in terms of my own personal journey into AI, it's been an interesting one. I think when ChatGPT came around, I was one of the first 5 million people that signed up in the first week and started using this technology to just see what it's like. It ticks a lot of boxes, doesn't it? It gives validation to our thoughts. It answers the questions that we have. And instead of searching for information on places like Google, it gives you a structured answer. It is able to converse with you like an actual human being would. If you ask a question in a simple way, it gives you an answer in a simple way. You can even adjust the tone in which it answers. You can make it play roles of scientists, of therapists, of personal trainers. Sky is the limit. You can train your own personal GPT to be able to do certain things that you want it to do and no more. You can restrict its knowledge base by giving it certain bits of information. A lot of companies use a knowledge-based model of sorts that is able to take all the information that is within a company database and produce some sort of chatbot that you can interact with. So no more searching for documents on company search. You can have an agent or an AI that can have all the access to all the information on your company database for your employees to be able to interact with that information using simple prompts and simple language like you do with ChatGPT. And that's what's very possible these days to design and deploy within a matter of days. Other applications that I've seen of AI that I find very interesting, of course, is voice. So you can have an AI-based receptionist. So imagine a GPT being designed to know everything that you know and is able to answer questions from people that are trying to reach you. A professional practice like a dentistry service or a martial arts studio, there is literally no limit to what is the kind of application that you can use a chat-based service for. And this can be now done in voice, and it can even have emotion. So depending on how you train the model and the voice, it can respond to queries that your customers have. You won't have to miss out on people calling at a time that you're not able to answer the phone. No more needing a receptionist to be able to answer the call whenever somebody calls. It can be 24/7. It can work without breaks. It doesn't need holidays. It doesn't fall sick. It doesn't throw tantrums. And most of all, it does not make errors. So the efficiency improvements with AI are massive. There are countries like India, where I was speaking to some of my friends who have expressed that deploying AI in a place like India is still going to take some time, but they have also at the same breath expressed that the accuracy of AI definitely trumps even the aspect of cheap labor. So we as human beings will need to learn to evolve and to do things that are more worth our intelligence and our effort than just doing simple manual tasks that are repetitive and administrative. Other applications of AI that I have seen can be in sales. You can have an agent reach out to all your prospects in a fashion that is automated. You can identify some of the clients that you have already worked with, refine and define their characteristics, and let the AI form judgments on how those people are, the ones that you would like to work with, and for it to find more of those kinds of people and be able to tailor messages that can be sent to them in your tone of voice, in your style of speaking and saying things and writing things, so that these messages can be hyper-personalized and they actually land in your prospect's inbox and they actually want to respond to those messages, versus some sort of spammy message that you may be sending or somebody else might be sending on your behalf. It's now become so advanced, the technology has moved on to the extent that you can get suggestions of beautifully crafted messages, whether it's in the form of text messages or emails, that can be used to reach out to your prospects and is able to actually bring you results that are better than a human being doing that in the first place. I could make a whole video about all sorts of applications that can be used in sales, but in terms of marketing, you can have content that can be written by AI in your tone of voice, in your style of speaking. It can summarize information for you. It can take a piece of text and produce variations of that information so that it can be used as content for your marketing and for your services that you provide. Customer service is a big one. Obviously, I spoke of when people can use agents to answer the phone, to train that model by giving it the knowledge, giving it the information that it needs to answer frequently asked questions and book appointments and take care of booking various things that you need to remember. Human beings can now be doing more important things that require them to do what needs to be done. Things like caring for someone, things like having an actual conversation is still something that human beings are well and truly able to do much better than AI. But let the first instance of the communication that happens between you and your prospects, when they are not necessarily bought into your services, once they are slightly interested or bought in, that's when the human being can take over and take control of the conversation and be able to, let's say, seal the deal. So that's just sales and marketing and customer service. When it comes to delivering your product, especially in the energy industry, you can have AI managing all sorts of data that is being produced from historical sources, from current usage of your devices that you have installed on your customer sites, and be able to predictively know when something's about to go wrong, monitor the information that's coming through to know where and in what direction your solar panels, for example, or your wind turbines need to be located so that they can produce the maximum output. They can also be telling you when they require maintenance, because there's patterns in data that can be recognized based on historic data when things are about to go wrong, and give you the information that you require to make those all important decisions quicker and more efficiently. While earlier we used to use it just to check a word, now it's being used to check whole sentences and paragraphs and even letters that are being sent from one person to another. So these are very basic applications of AI, the spell check aspect and something like correcting an email or making it sound more warm or making it sound less confrontational. These are applications that are most commonly used. That's what made the likes of ChatGPT so popular. It was an agent that allowed people to interact with it as if they were talking to a human being and have that conversation without feeling judged. So having those conversations was always possible with other human beings as well. But what made things like ChatGPT so popular and so able to do that, even in some cases better than human beings, was because of its non-judgmental way of coming across. It will answer your questions without fail, it might make some errors sometimes, and it says that it will, but AI is so good with people wanting to use it and being able to reason with people's questions and give them answers that they need. And a lot of times it is self-validating. It will give you answers that you want to hear, but it's important to ask the right questions. Garbage in is garbage out. That is the most important principle of AI that I would like to leave you with. So, my friends, AI is not here to get you. It's here to help you. Use it to facilitate your life. Use it to do more of what you love and less of what you don't. If you want to have a conversation about how AI can improve your life and genuinely make you more productive, make you more profitable and may have more money in your pocket. There's a link in the description below. Click on it. Let's have a quick chat to see what's possible. If not, no worries. I love you and leave you. Bye.